I didn't mean to have crazy face, but I had crazy face, didn't
yeah.
I?
Yeah. Hey, guys.
How's it going? Welcome to the Beer and Video Games Variety Show. We are your perennial hosts.
Perennial, always humble, always humbled by our own skills.
Yes, that too, that's the most important part always, of our personas.
Yeah, always humbled by our sheer lack of technical prowess.
And our inability to do anything correctly.
Yeah. But we'll tell you something about tonight. Everything's gone perfectly so far.
That's true.
So we have
That's definitely true.
We have very good feelings about tonight.
Yeah, you know, we started early. And by that, I mean we started late.
Yeah.
We are not doing the beer we thought we would do, because why would we?
I was trying to keep that under wraps. I was saying everything was going perfect.
I think we have an obligation to be honest.
Yeah.
I think our truest fans love us because we're inept. It's basically what makes us distinct from everybody else on YouTube.
So we should start a Patreon for our four fans, and they should each give us like $500 a month to be honest on camera.
Yep, we got it. I think that's a good. That's the pyramid.
That's what
scheme.
The YouTube tip said, right? Be yourselves.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. Welcome to the Beer and Video Games Variety Show.
After a long, long preface.
Yeah, I think that all good things have a caveat.
Yeah, so, you know, all things considered, I think that we got an awesome game set up.
Yeah, this is one of the games that...
In HD.
Ooh.
It's going to look real nice, I think. That's PS1 HD, which is very different than modern day HD. It's going to be nice. We're talking Tenchu Stealth Assassins.
Right. Now, I guess there's a history to this game for both of us. We both played Tenchu 2 and Tenchu Wrath of Heaven.
Yeah.
Now, Bear is more familiar with Tenchu.
Yeah, the first one. It's been years still.
Yeah, I mean, I'm familiar with it. I played it. But the thing is that my friend had Tenchu, and I had Tenchu 2. Yeah. So, obviously, because I own Tenchu 2, that was the game that, you know, for me, when I think back to what is Tenchu, well, it's Tenchu Wrath of Heaven, but it really, like, the fountainhead for me is Tenchu 2, whereas for you, it's 1. But I think that we both agree that Tenchu Wrath of Heaven is the best of that line, right?
Yeah, I'd say that, you know, Wrath of Heaven improved on everything without losing anything, so
right.
I'd have to say. That,
and that's rare.
Yeah, exactly.
We'll be talking about that
next week. I think this three-part system, I think it goes by, like, the Bioshock growth, where it's like Bioshock 1, awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome game.
By the way.
Bioshock 2 went to a different developer. Complete shit game. And then there's, like, a fucking 15-year gap, and then it's, like, Bioshock 3, Tenchu 3, and they're both better in every respect than their predecessors.
Right.
So.
Yeah, so that's, I really wanted to, hold on, sorry. Continue.
We look forward to killing merchants, around, you know. But we can talk about the game itself after why don't we get to the beer?
Yeah, so... We were going to do the Stochasticity Project, Master of Disguise. It's a stout, but it's golden, so it's a bit of an enigma.
Yeah, but you know, we decided that was two on the head, or two on the nose.
Yeah,
you know, too easy for us.
So we moved on to this bad boy right here. So
Payback port. Oh, look at that autofocus.
That's real nice.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah. So we got Speakeasy Payback Porter. As you can see, there's this detective and another shadowy figure right there. Payback.
Looking for payback. And as we know, Tenchu is all about the payback.
It is.
Everybody's paying back Erbuddy.
Erbuddy's paying Erbuddy back.
Oh, yeah. It's all about revenge. There's little to do with that ninja code so much as, like, I mean, you need to assassinate people who kind of fucked up.
Right. Well, yeah, because, I mean, you're working to stop something, right?
Yeah.
So, I mean, you're I don't know, you're getting the evildoers.
You are. You're knocking them out.
And yeah, that is kind of like Michael Shannon on the bottle. So Let's see. Before we keep on going, let's say our hellos to everyone. All right, so Vexy's here. What's up, Vexy? Good to stop by. For all of those who are wondering, Vexy's one of our moderators, and she has a YouTube channel, and she always gives us nice shout-outs. So everybody...
She's going to draw us in chibi forms and make a logo for us.
Yeah, she's going to make Chibi Jack and Chibi Bear, so that'll be fun. So I guess give Vexy's channel a visit and a like or a subscribe. She's one of our best. Then we've got Hello Blue. What's up, Hello Blue? Thanks for coming. I hope Big Trouble's there with you. And if he is, what's up, Big Trouble? Then we've got Lena Fitz making the connections between beer and Michael Shannon, which I think there needs to be more of those in the world. Then we've got let's see, Spooky Donkey. What's up, Bill? How you doing? And yeah, we're excited for Tenchu as well.
It's going to be real fun.
Yeah, I haven't played Tenchu in a day and a half.
We're going to get busted.
We're going to get busted, yeah, because we're out of practice. Yeah. But, and this was kind of like an impromptu thing.
You can't phone in a stealth game.
No.
You cannot.
No, so it's going to be really interesting. Like I think everybody knows by now, we have a track record of messing up.
Yeah.
So this should be funny for you, frustrating for us, but probably good for everyone.
Yeah.
So, let's get back to the Tenchu conversation. We really want to play Tenchu Wrath of Heaven, but it's a PS2 game and it's harder to run.
Yeah.
So
it's a whole pain when it comes to streaming.
Yeah, Bear doesn't like Tenchu 2.
But Tenchu 2 is awful. It is objectively bad.
I obviously it's the game for me that I started the franchise on. So for me, that is just, you know, that is the beginning of Tenchu. I can't really remember what one is like.
Yeah.
So it's going to be interesting.
You're going to find out.
Yeah. I kind of wish we had Wrath of Heaven because that game is a lot of fun.
It is.
I love that.
Yeah,
game.
Tenchu 1 is fun as well.
Yeah. I'm assuming it is. Yeah. The whole. I don't know, like the whole Tenchu story is really compelling, I think.
Yeah.
I like the way that they told it kind of, you know, out of order and all that stuff. And, you know,
it was a very pragmatic aesthetic choice.
Yeah.
In that Rikimaru dies.
Yeah. You know?
And then they're like, part three, they're like, nah, fuck that.
Yeah. One does not simply kill Rikimaru.
Yeah.
So, it's going to be fun. Let's talk about why we chose the Payback Porter. Pouring a little thin, but it's a porter. It's not a stout, so I'm not going to fault it.
Why are we even drinking it? All dark beers should be stouts always.
I think so, too. So, Payback, you know, it's pretty obvious. Rikimaru dies, and then he comes back. And then, like, he comes...
Well, I mean,
he dies, and then you see him as a young lad. Yeah.
A strapping young ninja.
Yeah, and then he's resurrected.
Yeah.
And then he goes and he kills the villain.
Well, here's the thing. You remember the villain in Tenchu 3? Like, you have your counterpart, like that evil... Like, I think he punches.
Yeah.
He's all fists. You know who I'm talking about?
Yeah, I think so.
Super, like, snake person looking. That dude's in the first one, and he has beef with you already in the first one. He's got beef. You got
just a lot of beef.
You got history. He wants to pay your ass back.
Yeah. So, I mean, there's just payback all around.
He's my favorite guy to play as in part three, though. He's so much fun.
Yeah. I really liked the multiplayer.
The maps
were surprisingly big for
and
for
I liked style, you know? I liked the killer chiropractor. That guy is
Tetsumaru. He's your friend, isn't he? Doesn't he start off as your friend?
Two? But he doesn't like you very much in part one. Or part three.
Yeah.
Because his ass is resurrected too.
Yeah.
To kill you. He's your anathema.
Break out the Lanham guide to rhetorical devices.
Yeah.
So, let's see. Of course, it's a ninja game.
Yeah.
So it had to look like this. The beer had to look like this. So here you go, guys. look at his. Look at his, because that We just need to do that.
Yeah.
So this is like some pretty midnight black stuff. Only if you hold it up to the light do you really get some variance in it, right?
Yeah.
And it turns into like a almost like a Coca-Cola brown.
Yeah, but you know the head actually looks really nice around the edges. It's darker.
Well, yeah, like in the middle it's a bit more like khaki. Milky, but it has like a... Yeah, like a darker tinge to it on the edges.
That's nice. I like that. I don't see that too often.
Well, yeah, I usually get that.
Even when you agitate it, it gets a nice autumn.
Yeah, you know? It's a good head. So there we go. I think we found a beer that we could say, like, the appearance is, you know, like a 4.
Okay.
Because the head is so lovely. And the head is, I mean, that's some good lacing. Head retention, yeah. Right?
Hey, age pretty.
There you go. All right, so let's go ahead and give it a sniff. Yeah, just...
not very much body. It's nice. It's pleasant. It's clean. It's fresh.
Yeah. It's
it's very fresh.
It's just like malty and a bit sugary.
Yeah.
Not a whole lot going on aromatically.
Like a cool breeze through a candy factory.
It's got a touch of, just like a touch of smoke. Just a little bit.
Hmm.
But I actually got my nose in it, so that's why I'm getting that. Like, it got on my nose.
Yeah.
But yeah, mostly it's just real, real, like, chocolate, malty.
It's
and,
light.
Yeah.
You know, it is delightful, I think. I think it's nice, just not much to it.
Yeah, I'd say it's overly simplistic and a tiny bit like aromatically challenged. I'm not getting a huge like fucking
cornucopia.
I'm
gonna get it up on my nose. I'm gonna get it up.
Yeah. All right. Well, let's get into it. Cheers, guys. Clink.
God, that focus.
Yep.
You know, I think we. If we do that, we could do this show in, like, 3D. Like, cheers, guys. Ooh. Put on your glasses now.
Yeah, we got to get, like, a red and blue glass.
Yeah. You know what? I'm actually picking up that smokiness on the way out.
There's a lot of smokiness on this, actually.
Only on the way out, though.
Yeah.
Not too much.
Definitely.
Oh, I know.
Definitely smoky.
Yeah. That's nice, actually. You know, I've never gotten smoke on a beer this light.
Yeah.
You know, or thin. It's usually those thick, viscous stouts that'll do it to you.
And this is the right amount of smoky for what, like, for the base beer, you know?
Yeah.
Like, the base beer is not chocolatey. And if it is, it's really bitter chocolatey. Like, this is almost like a hop. Like, I can taste the hops in this porter, you know? Like, there is a tiny bit of that astringency on it. It's a tiny bit crackery, like saltines in the aftertaste, kind of like that type of malt, rather than like a coffee malt or a chocolate malt. It's kind of like a bready malt. And then, yeah, I mean, because there isn't a whole lot going on in the base, you can't have like a smoke bomb, you know?
Yeah.
Like Smoking Wood is a beer by the brewery that has just like way too much smoke in it. I think this is just right.
Yeah, I agree. It's nice.
Wish there was more to it though.
Yeah. We're not used to drinking porters around these parts.
I like porters though.
Yeah. But we're not used to it. We've been on the stout train, we've been on the Belgian.
This is our only porter that we've done in the entirety, like even the Let's Plays. And all of the previous stuff. It's always been stouts.
You know, we needed a subtle beer for the subtle art of assassination.
There you go.
Yeah.
Bear nose.
Yeah. The smoke is the smoldering anguish of those who can no longer defend themselves.
Well, and it's also smoke bombs. You have smoke bombs in Tenchu 1, right? I think so, yeah. So that works.
Yeah, you get little rice balls.
I have a little bit more. Okay, how about the mouthfeel? What do you think?
Yeah, thin. I mean, it's...
Yeah, thin and a bit watery. Like,
yeah.
It doesn't leave a film, which, I mean, for me, with a smoky beer, Yeah, I guess that's good.
Yeah.
Like, I wouldn't want a smoky, like, overly viscous porter to begin with. Yeah. So, eh.
It's nice.
Yeah.
It's good.
Yeah, it's good.
It is.
Yeah, I mean, this is only, like, a $5 bottle.
Yeah.
If
you're into porters, I would recommend it.
Yeah, yeah. Porters are... You have to like porters for this to work. Because it's very portery. This is definitely out of the stout area. And this is like... You know, a porter is kind of hard to... it's kind of hard to say like what makes a porter. But I would say that this is like a really solid display of what a porter should do. Mm-hmm. You know? Just have a really solid malty backbone. A little bit of sugary note. And then support something interesting like smoke or a little bit of chocolate.
Yeah. Very drinkable. Something to be said about the drinkability.
Yeah, despite the smokiness. Because I usually think that smokiness, you kind of have to sip.
Yeah.
But not this one.
That's nice.
Yeah. All right.
So we'll keep that in consideration.
Yeah. So let's go ahead and rate the beer.
Appearance. Dropped out four.
Yeah.
That quad.
Yeah. The quad, bro. The
quad. We're going to be dropping quad nines.
Like a Final Fantasy X character.
Nah, dog.
No.
They get to the five. What's
the quint.
The quint nines?
Quint nines. Yeah.
Pent nines?
No, yeah, it could be pent nines.
Pent nines. Yeah. Quint nines.
Pent nines.
Pent nines.
We'll say that. Pent nines. All right, so how about the aroma? I'm giving it like a 3.
3?
I think it's a little aromatically challenged.
So especially, you're going to give it a 3? Wouldn't you give it lower for that?
No, yeah.
A 3
is
average.
It's average, so I'm going to say like 2.5.
Okay.
Because honestly, even though you can get a kind of like a sample of what this beer is like in the taste,
it's not sufficient.
It's not at all. Like with a bigger beer, like... I just have Tsukaba on the mind because it's coming out this like in the next 2 weeks or so. Mm. Like with Tsukaba, you smell it and you're like, okay, this is what I'm going to get into. And then the beer is bigger.
Bigger beer.
Yeah, but the thing is, it's not like, oh, this is a completely different beer. I'm picking up on so many different things that I am. You know, so 2.5 on the smell. What about you?
Yeah, I could agree with that. I think we're on the same page.
3
on this beer.
Okay, so 3 for taste.
I would almost want to put it above average on taste just because of how hard it is, like you said, to get that smoke and balanced drinkability with all those
things. That's really fair. Yeah, 3.5.
Let's kick that up.
And I'll give the mouthfeel a 3 because it's average.
Okay. We'll do that. And
then overall, 3.5.
3.5, 3.75, that range. That kind of... It's going above, but we're not into that top tier 4 yet.
Yeah.
It's...
All right, so there we go, guys.
It's good.
Overall, we just got a 3.63.
Yeah, I like it.
There we go.
I like it. is there anything we want to say about ninjas and killing people before we can just throw it on?
Oh, well, give them that nice fact.
Hey, the Flying V is here.
Flying V 42, what's up, man? Then we've got Matt lurking. So what's up, Matt?
Bert can have his way with this one.
Yeah, hello, Burke.
So we can let you in on a little factoid here. This is actually... I actually learned this from Holland Piggy. She was the one who let me in on that. So our conception of what ninjas look like, the full black, you know, skin tight, only the eyes showing, is not an accurate representation of how ninjas dressed back in the day. You know, they would generally wear street clothes because that's easier to assassinate someone in because they're not expecting it, right? Our conception, that aesthetic kind of look that they have, comes from kabuki theater. It comes from dramatism. Now, when people would be doing kabuki theater, they needed stagehands because it's drama. You need to change the sets, but you don't want that to be a cumbersome affair. So what they do is they dress the stagehands completely in black with only their eyes showing. And they would move behind the characters and move the sets and do whatever needed to be done. Now, just like in Western theater, we have the conception of Deus Ex Machina, where almost seemingly unknowing in a play, you know, the hand of God, like that, comes down and completely changes the course of the play and kind of saves everyone or damns everyone, but it just comes out of nowhere. Whereas in Kabuki theater, what they would do is when they need to assassinate someone, the best way to assassinate somebody completely in a surprising way would be to make one of the stagehands do it. They're dressed in black. You are actively trying to ignore them. And while you're ignoring them, they jump up, murder someone on stage, pull off their mask and be like, it was me the whole time. You didn't even notice, kind of thing. So every time we see a ninja dressed like that, that is from theater. Kabuki theater. You learn something new.
Lethal Bacon, what's up? Yeah, Bukkake theater. That's dyslexic.
Funny story theater. About Bukkake theater.
They wear a lot of masks.
No, but no shit. Do you know how they got that name?
How?
Okay, so did you know that that's a style of food, Bukkake? Like, there's a place in LA called Bukkake Noodles.
Okay.
And it's because what you do is you have the noodles by themselves and you pour the broth into it.
Oh, yeah.
That's... Are you making the connection? Do we need to take a stop at Connection Corner?
Now, here's the thing about Bukkake, guys.
We'll leave it at that.
Yep. We're going to make a highlight of the first season.
Am I a weeaboo?
I think so.
Oh.
So when we make the greatest hits of season one, or like the first 10 episodes... We should smash it all into a one minute video of us fucking up. Yeah, essentially. Yeah. Think about Bukkake theater.
We need to get that to be like a dubstep. Like a dubstep remix. Yeah. Think about Bukkake theater.
It's coming, guys. Just like Bukkake theater.
Oh!
And with that being said, this is our first glass of beer. There's more to come,
not
guys.
Not even almost drunk. Let's just get to the game. We fucked it up.
Please love us still.
We love you.
All right. Oh, boy.
Go on.
Why don't you have this set up? Okay, well, anyways.
This one runs a little different.
Do you even have editing software? To make this mashup?
No.
Okay.
I was hoping our fans would do it.
Yeah, we need a fan video of our...
Vexy, make chibi... No. Really do make chibi versions of us, but don't edit anything for us. Somebody else can do that.
I would like to see... Yeah, Bill, you should make a great... like a blooper reel for us.
I would genuinely like to see the chibs, though.
Oh, yeah, chibi versions of us. And our chibi hair is going to be just, like, amazing. Or at least mine will be. Your chibi beard will be great. And my long, flowing, golden locks. That's where it's going to be. What's up?
Just let us know how the sound is working, yeah?
All right. I think I can hear that.
Yeah, but it's different for them.
Okay.
It's always a little different.
Yeah, Bill's into making GIFs. Or GIFs, whatever you want to say. So Bill can help us with making the blooper reel or the gag reel.
Here we go. We're going
to
get this.
And then you just have to put, like, really, really quietly put Yakety Sax behind it.
Just take a listen to that. Ooh. Is that doing it for you?
It is. The bass, bro.
It's all about the bass.
That's right. There we go. All right. That's a decent sized window, I suppose.
Yeah, I think so. It's fine.
It's not the worst thing I've ever seen. But that said, well, whatever. This is not for you. It's looking good on the...
Yeah, it looks fantastic.
Yeah, look at that.
I told you.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. I can get behind that.
See? Oh, it's so good.
Yeah, so share your Tenchu experiences with us, guys. Yame, Rikimaru.
If you're not a killer chiropractor, you better be Rikimaru. But you had Wrath of Heaven, right? You had the killer chiropractor. He's the secret character after you beat it with Rikimaru and Ayame.
Mm.
And he's the one who silently first snaps both of their arms and then their neck. which, you know, is the best way to kill someone silently. Break two of their limbs and then the fatal one. Right. But he also had awesome ones where he got acupuncture needles and shoved it through their eyes.
Oh, God.
That's so metal. I'm so excited.
I think the hairstyles are pretty contained in this game, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. This isn't, like, too crazy anime, I suppose. Punish the evil merchant. Oof.
Give them a little narration here. Sound?
Yeah, how's the sound, guys? Class have become rich, but the merchant
class is a large step below nobility. That's real small. Cannot become a samurai. This caused many merchants to. See, now the music's real loud for me, but I can't hear the narration. I can't hear the voices. Ichigoya began his career as an honest trader. But that could very well be because these are running out of batteries.
That's not good for anyone. His methods are
brutal. His profit fast. You can go grab us some more. Arrested, where are they? They're right outside in the that little. Can pay for his crimes with his life. Okay, what do we want? Healing potion. Should be, yeah, right in there somewhere. The smallest ones, yeah.
Two of them?
Yeah, one, just one. Okay, so I brought some healing potion.
Yeah.
Some smoke bomb.
Yeah.
I don't think I want caltrips.
Yeah.
Use as a trail marker. No. That's stupid. A grenade. It's a little not subtle, you know?
Yeah, no.
Maybe the caltrips. So when somebody's chasing
you.
Yeah,
that's good.
Okay, let's go from here. Could just take everything.
Yeah.
Poison rice. I mean, there's no harm in taking it.
Take out the poison rice and put in a shuriken.
Where is the poison?
That's a lot of cheating, Flying V. Let's see. My OCD kicking. Game sound is a bit low, is what they're saying.
Okay.
Yeah, they can't hear it. All right. Oh, what kind of wine are you drinking, Vexy? Here's your battery. Right here.
That ought to do it. How does it sound now? I turned it up.
How's it sound, guys? Bourbon and Coke. Not even Costco beer.
I'm all about bourbon and Coke.
I think bourbon by itself is sweet enough. Is that like a bum battery or something?
I think so. God, no, it's not. It's
okay. We good? Bum battery?
Maybe.
Did you put it in the right way?
No.
Bear.
There we go. All right.
Avoid the main gate. Use the grappling hook. Never harm the innocent. I love the grappling hook. grappling hook.
Okay, so this shit's like pretty blaring in my ears. So I hope it sounds good for them.
Yeah, I can hear it.
Yeah. So this is what you do.
Is it loud, guys?
Oh, it's inverted.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm so sneaky.
This is Tenchu 1?
Yeah.
Okay.
Why?
Because... Yeah, I... Okay. Oh, yeah, that sound effect, though. And, okay, so in the corner you got that little question mark. The higher the number, the more likely somebody is to see you, right?
Yes, I believe so. They gonna chime in on the sound?
Yeah, what's the sound like, guys? Oh, Jesus. Hello Blue is drinking Hello Blue's infamous Singapore slang. Let's see.
Oh, what'd I do?
Alright, some Italian red wine. Yeah, some good stuff. Hold up. Did you throw a shuriken?
I did.
Yeah, go back and pick that shit up.
Nah, it's stupid. You suck.
Oh, snap. What is that?
It's a dude. He wasn't here last time.
Nice.
You dumb bitch.
That's what you get when you nap on the job.
That's what you get when you find a stranger in the Alps, dog.
That is exactly what happens when you find a stranger in the Alps.
I hope they can hear this because Echigoya's voice acting is gold. Here we go.
Come on! Come on! What? Who are you?
I'm here to avenge all the innocent people you've hurt.
That's right.
Somebody help!
Somebody help!
Rick Mori, get canceled!
Oh, what am I gonna do?
This is with Echigoya. Step aside, or I will have to kill you.
Oh, snap.
Come on! You dumb bitch. What? What are you gonna do? Oh shit.
Uh-oh.
The last hit. Backflips!
I love that blocking sound.
Bing! Echigoya.
Captain and Coke. Hidden. Is now Captain and Pepsi?
So, Echigoya has now run away and I don't know where he went. I just remember how to get to him. But I know it's smart to stay up on the rooftops. Does anybody know where Echigoya could have gone?
Didn't he run out the door?
Yeah, which was this way. I mean, you want me to search for him on the ground floor? You want to get crazy with it?
Let's get crazy with it, bro. Boom.
Damn it.
Damn. Way less cool than that could have been.
Okay, can I press up on the wall? Can I do that? I'm not. Maybe if I...
No. Is it, is it the L2 and R2 bumper?
It's R1.
R1, okay. Okay, so he just ran out into the... Oh, shit. Get back, get back. Get back.
I can't get... I can't! I can't! Guys!
You're spotted, bro.
Am I, though?
I think so, right? No, okay. You're good.
So
what are you...
He ran
out
this
way. What are you doing, Carl?
Oh, I see.
Get him.
Skater! There's a way to, like, actually assassinate
Yeah, I
them,
thought there was, like, an assassination button.
There is. I don't know what it is. That was cool, though.
So Flying V says, if I may backseat a little bit here. Cheat! Cheat like the wind! Damn camera angles, though.
Yeah, it's auto. He's back there. In that door.
Who knows? Not me.
How the fuck did I do that? Alright.
What was that noise? Oh shit. Ooh, what's
in here?
Is that
a trash can?
Yeah, go slice the trash can open. See if there's an onion in there.
There could be dogs, though.
Oh, that's a boat. It looks like a boat.
Oh, that was fucking sweet. Hey, I hear a lady yelling for help.
Save her, Ricky Maru. You're her only hope. Oh, snap, there he is.
That's not him. Yeah. That's one of his crones.
It's a crone. You gotta kill the crony.
Backflips! Bitch!
Skater!
Whoa! He's good! He's good, guys! Dude, that guy's got blocks. Like, there's no tomorrow. What the hell?
He's pushing your shit in. Oh.
Dude, that guy was a samurai.
Get that hell potion. Oh, behind you.
Yeah, I know. See, I think the screaming's coming from over here. There she is.
What are you supposed to do to her?
I don't know.
Oh, kill that guy. Oof. Clunkers.
Oh, yeah!
We're very effective ninjas. Get him. Oh boy.
Backflip.
He just run into his lunge.
Worked, didn't it?
Alright.
Okay, so screaming woman, not the best indicator of where this dude is.
This is... You're good. You're good.
For now.
I like the way that Ricky Maru runs.
Yeah. Stream. Where do you think Echigoya is?
He ran away, bro. Kill this spear
there's, guy. Oh, there's two of them.
Nice. Ruin him. Ruin him! Nice.
What?
You ruined him in style. You jumped on... Well, never mind. What? Those blood effects, they're real nice.
Yeah.
I love the blocky blood. It reminds me of Bushido Blade. The blood in Bushido Blade is kind of hilarious. It's like really blocky and I don't know.
Dude,
it's pretty horrible.
As a kid, I freaking had this entire game memorized.
Like, yeah, me too. Not no mo.
It's been a while.
Oh, looks like your little bro's here. Yeah, this is old school, isn't it?
Ask if he remembers. He played this game a lot.
Do you remember this game, Kevin?
Where's Echigoya?
Where's Echigoya? I would imagine that he is, in a house.
Uh-huh.
Perhaps.
There's a guard. Nah, dog, it's fine.
Yeah, Kevin doesn't remember much. Surprise, surprise. It's alright, we don't remember either. But we're old, and you're in the peak of your youth. Get it, skater.
Okay, so here's the garden.
Yeah. You can see what items we took in the bottom right-hand corner.
Well, oh, no, you can't. Our faces.
Yeah, so we took a smoke bomb, potions, shurikens, and the little things that you throw on the floor so the guards, like, fuck up their feet. Even though Bear is strategically not using those.
Caltraps.
Your brother doesn't know what fucking caltraps are. Bushido Blade, where it was legit to lay on your back and just slash your sword because both your legs and your left arm had major muscles and tendons.
That was fucking awesome. You see that?
Do you come down on him like Sephiroth?
Yeah. Nice. Watch it on replay.
Here we go. I'm going to watch it on replay. Let's see what happened. Too bad you can't kill people with your grappling hook. Let's see.
We need that on replay. Oh, it's not yet. You wait for it. Oh, man, they haven't even seen it yet. They're going to love it.
I can't wait for them to be happy.
What? Right here.
You're gonna jump on him. Boom, there we go.
Are you fucking
it directed you down there. Yeah, he bled a lot. There was a lot of blood involved in that kill.
Hit. Oh, there's two of them.
Oh, Skeeter. But,
wait, is that actually going?
I don't know.
No, I don't think so, but...
I don't think he would be... There you go.
I missed... It's okay, though.
Oh, there we go! That's the Ricky Maru I remember. Boom. Love it.
Come on. Ah! You bitch! Oh! Ah!
He shadow stepped you.
Backflip!
You love the backflip.
It gets you out of range from their counterattack.
That's right. Dude, I'm finally hearing the sound effect of the blood. It's real nice.
What's this?
I don't know.
Ooh, a grenade? Okay, I think he's in one of these storerooms.
Just like hiding.
Yeah, like a bitch.
Maybe that's just decorative.
There's a dog.
There's a dog. Hello, Doge. Wow.
I don't like the dog.
So ninja. Very shuriken.
Wow. Oh, shit.
What?
Did a backflip.
Is the Doge after you?
Yeah, they're just kind of a pain.
Yeah. Can you kill the Doge?
See, I understand humans. Yeah, you can kill the Doge.
You gotta kill the Doge.
You can't sneak up on a Doge.
No, because they have Doge senses.
Yeah.
Let's see. What's going on? Oh, I see that.
Dirty bitch. Somebody!
Your bodyguards are dead.
Your bodyguards are dead.
And you are next.
I jumped on them from the roof. It was badass. There we go. That's what I was waiting for, his fucking gun.
Get him. Get him. Skater.
I wish you could hear his whimpering.
Get him.
Oh!
Skater!
Oh! Oh!
Nice.
Tell me that's not a commentary on the mercantilism of the times.
There we go.
I hope your death is a lesson to others.
Me too.
And I hope somebody saw me do that because I was totally fucking badass.
Undetected kills.
Master Ninja.
Yeah, there you go. There you go, buddy.
I know.
Spotted six
times. Is Lethal Bacon still here? Because he gets off on Master Ninjas.
Are you here, Lethal Bacon?
Can we just look?
Let's see.
I hope he saw that shit.
Yep, there he is.
Oh, good. Master Ninja.
What beer relates with Tenchu? Master of Disguise and Payback Porter. Let me show you, buddy. There you go. That's that should be good. Oh wait.
Yeah, sure.
Dakota's territory. You have stolen a copy of their plans.
Alright.
His forces will crush the outlaws at little cost.
Without so can you even save in this game?
Goda faces a brutal fight. The enemy has sent a group of ninja to the town outside.
So Flying V says, I'm not going to say that you should cheat. I'm just saying if you hold R1, that then hit left triangle cross, which I'm guessing is X. L1. And then you let go. It's totally not cheating, and only awesome happens.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. 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 Did you pick up anything new? Yeah, isn't that a claymore?
Where?
Here?
Yeah. A mine. It's period accurate. That's, okay, got my Heelys. Let's get some Smokies.
Yeah.
You want a landmine?
No.
I'm gonna have you play this level, so.
I want some shurikens. I like me some shurikens.
You got it. There's a bunch of them.
Yeah. And then give me some caltrops, bro.
There you go.
Caltrops.
There you go. So I don't think you can save in this game. I think it's a once through.
Maybe.
Didn't ask me to save. It didn't prompt me, so.
Mark your path with colored rice. Beware of enemies on the roof.
I'm not gonna do.
Never harm the innocent. Deliver the secret message. This is with the analog sticks, right?
No.
No?
This is PS1.
Oh, okay, yeah, that's right.
I sense danger.
I sense danger.
Triangle to use item.
Yeah. I best hurry.
Yeah, it's inverted.
Yeah, I play inverted. So.
Oh!
Let's see. Jump. What's circle do?
I don't know.
Crouch?
I thought that was R1. Crouch was R1, I thought.
It's both, apparently. And then to look, okay. Then okay, let's see.
Could throw a shuriken at the dog.
I'm not gonna do that. It's a waste of a shuriken.
Not if you get a dead dog.
That's right. Because the dog sucks. Alright, so what am I doing again? What was the aim of this mission?
You gotta deliver a secret message. Oh, this is gonna help you.
Okay, I was gonna say.
Because I just heard somebody say, help! Help!
Let's see what we got. Alright, nothing. Alright. Let's go that way. What we got?
Yeah. Dog!
He literally fucked me up. Alright, where are we at? Okay. Let's see.
Rice patties.
Here. Nothing's over here. Okay, so I must have to go into
one of these
or something. Where is that dog? I'm gonna fucking kill it.
What?
What?
Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, does that guy have some psi?
That's a female?
She have some psi? Backflip.
Wow, this girl's like fucking me up. How do you block again?
Yeah, that's what, I don't know. Did you see me block? Oh! Oh! Hardcore parkour! Oh, you're screwed. This place is inhabited by, like, demon ninja.
Oh. Dude, camera angles are killing me.
If somebody could, look up how to block. You gotta wait for your swing. You can't just go all foolhardy.
Oh, dude, you can't. Like, there is no good way to...
Yeah, flips. There you go. See, you're all flippy. There you go. One HP. There it is. Right in her neck. She's bleeding out all over the place. How about this guy? Yeah, you're going for the jump. What is he now? Oh no. Oh no. Yeah! You feeling the power? That is some sick ninjutsu.
There we go. Alright.
You felt the backflip. Now you know the power of the backflip.
Alright. Let's see if we can get into,
There's more.
No? What's killing me is the camera, man. I need me some camera.
Oh, the camera's fine.
Oh, the camera's horrible. And, let's see. There we go. Alright.
Okay, assassinator, just get up behind her and just give her the old chock.
Let's see, so how to block, hold down attack button. Okay, let's kill her.
Yes. Yeah,
boom! Slit her throat. Take that.
Oh god, didn't even try. There it is. You getting scared? You want back on the roof?
Yeah, I want to get on the roof.
Oh, he was on the roof. He was on the roof! Oh, that was so ninja. Go, just go. See if he follows you. I think he has... Oh, that was way too early.
Yep.
And then there's a dog. Oh, I'm seeing shit. You seeing shit? Ooh, a bridge. Yeah, cross the bridge. Oh, there's somebody on the roof. You see somebody on the roof?
Nope.
Keep going.
Oh, snap! Where you come from?
Goddamn ninjas. Okay, well.
Please forgive my late arrival.
But there's like a bunch of ninjas in there. Well, Lord Goda is waiting for you. Oh, Lord Goda. Come. He's gonna goad you into something.
Ooh, novice.
That was a short-ass mission. What the hell?
Yep. Man. That camera is horrible.
Nah, it's fine.
At least you have camera in Tenchu 2. Alright, guys. I'm gonna go rinse this out.
Bring back our
missing ninja is in a torture chamber deep under a dangerous forest. With orders to immediately free the captive, Lord Goda has released you from the ninja code, which forbids rescues.
This game looks like shoes.
And quickly.
Hmm. Health. Smoke bombs. Caltrops. Take some poison rice. I don't care. And PSO, is that Phantasy Star Online that you're talking about there? I'm in a forest. There are no roofs here.
Uh-oh. Are there branches on the trees that we can latch onto?
There are only people who see me. And square trees.
I love those square trees.
Well, you know how, like, in Japan they have square watermelons?
There you go.
That's what they grow from.
Mm. All right. I hope this is the IPA I like. Yeah.
It's just a stupid archer.
All right, so for those of you who are interested, I will show you the bottle once Bear is done getting shot in the dick with arrows.
In the air, in mid-goddamn air.
Get him.
What?
Oh, wow.
Dude, I'd hire this guy as a goddamn archer.
Yeah, he needs to be our new Skeeter. He's the Skeeter of the opposite team. Now you gotta kill the Shiba.
I haven't even killed the goddamn archer.
Where are you? Man. This would be so much easier if the camera didn't suck ass.
There are dogs everywhere.
It's Japan, bro.
Is that supposed to mean something to me?
Yeah, they've got Shibas and Rainbows, like, everywhere, just flying around. Yeah, I mean, like, look at Sniper Wolf. She has dogs.
Also not Japanese.
In a Japanese game.
God!
You need to set a landmine down.
In the words of Jack, Jesus cocksuck.
You like that?
Ooh, I'm getting some FPS problems. All right. Well, I killed the dog.
Now.
That was the FPS problem I
got. Here's our IPA. It's Wipeout by Port San Diego Brewer. Real nice stuff. If this is the one I'm thinking of, it's brewed with citrus rinds. And here is the awesome color. Look at that color. Look at it. Look at it.
Here we go. Here we go.
It's beautiful. Nice.
What a bitch.
Look at that. Bear. Admire it.
That's really nice, actually. You know? Hey, you done good. Okay, I'm gonna follow the old gaming adage, which is follow the wall. And
there you go.
There you go. Works erd time.
Erd time. All right, let's see what's going on in chat. Skeet Mario. Skeeter Mario. Although I remember that when this game was around, it was in the time of Ricky Martin.
Oh God!
And so when I would fuck up, I'd be like, "God damn it, Ricky Martin!" But that's not fair to Ricky Maru. What we got? Another guy napping on the job. Look at that!
I take your rights. Is there anything up any higher? Is that all this section is for? Yeah,
it's all that section's for, bro.
No.
Oh. Snap. Yeah, there you go.
Snapocles.
Alright, crouch.
Is Does this just take us to a higher terrace?
I guess so.
We did go up, right?
Yeah, I think so. There you go. There's another one. I can't see. Poke. R1.
I'm trying.
All right, now. You have to observe his pattern. All right, get him. Cut his throat, Skeets. Nope.
Whatever, he's dead.
Let's see what's going on.
Next guy, maybe we should try to feed some poison rice.
Ooh, rice on the floor that wasn't here a minute ago.
Hey, so, Haas, why are you so silent, my friend? Have you been here the whole time? Oh, wait. Are they gonna do that to you? Is that poison rice?
No, I think this is a trap, honestly. I'm gonna look into the situation.
Oh, that's a potion.
Yeah, well... Okay, no, they're just being good to me, I guess.
Well, look up. There was, like, some light, or...
I think that's just the lighting of the game.
Oh, okay. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, I just had to make sure. I steal your rice.
I take your rice. I eat it up!
You eat it right the fuck up. So, guys. Oh!
You!
What the fuck is... What is Tovas? That's not a video game.
Should be.
that's my favorite video game, actually. So,
My favorite game is Frozen Anna Birth a Baby. Anna Give Birth a Baby.
Anna Give Birth a Baby. There you go. That's a good one. That's gonna be our next long play. So, are you guys excited for next week? I know I am.
Horrowind? Sapporowind?
I think that Morrowind is going... Like, so many people are just going to have thoughts about that. You know, everybody's kind of has their own unique hierarchy of Elder Scrolls games.
Oh, shit.
You're gonna die, bro.
Never! Freedom!
Never end. Yeet it! Use a smoke bomb on this guy.
He doesn't deserve it.
He doesn't deserve it. John Wick. And then, let's see. A lot of divas. Okay. A lot of diva talk going on. Yes. Yes, you will. I can't even tell you how long I've been waiting to do a Morrowind episode. And I didn't even have to wait that long. I figured Morrowind would be, like, a year or two discussion.
Yeah.
I thought we'd really have to get up to it. And yeah, I want to play Fatal Frame, too. I've never played that game.
Is that a PS2 game?
And I always wanted to. No, it's a GameCube game, I thought.
Fatal Frame? You could be right, I don't know.
Or maybe it is a PS2 game. I don't know. Is Fatal Frame PS2, or is it GameCube? I thought it was GameCube for some reason. But I'm probably wrong.
This is what we're gonna do.
Xenogears is coming, Haas.
Oh, yes, it is.
Just, not anytime soon. Well, I'm thinking that summer would be the best time for like, the Final Fantasy series in Xenogears. Suikoden 2 is coming. Again, it'll probably be in the summer. Oh, okay, Fatal Frame is PS2. Okay, there we
That's
go.
That's what I thought. It's possible, but we'll see.
Yeah. Yeah, the summer is going to be really big. It's going to be real big. But we'll talk about that more.
Okay, so I've been in here already.
We're going to play Star Ocean...
No.
One, right?
Two. Second story.
Oh, okay. All right, yeah. So, yeah, Flying V, we are going to play Star Ocean 2. Boom! Get him!
Babush.
Babushka. Wipeout. Wipeout, from... see. It's gonna take forever, so I'll just say it.
Ew.
Wipeout IPA by port. Chrono Trigger we're playing too. Again, the summer is gonna be like the basically the golden age of RPG. Sorry. Summer would just be best because we'll both have a lot more time, I assume.
Yeah.
We don't need no goddamn strategy guide, Bill.
Oh shit.
So for those of you who played the Tenchu franchise, what do you think?
Do you see these ninja skills?
Yeah, you're doing all sorts of ninja skills. You're doing ninja skills. So for those of you who have played these games, Tenchu 1, 2, and Wrath of Heaven, let's exclude the others.
I always get freaking lost on this level. I remember it now.
Yeah. How do you rate them? Go ahead and tell us. You gotta get over that pitfall. There you go.
This looks like the way to go, right?
Looks like Indiana Jones. Yeah, get that guy.
I'm not fighting on that thing.
No.
He could fight on it if he wants, but...
Backflip! No!
Damn, we got far in that level too.
Oh man, that is rough. That is rough. And you made a very conscious effort.
That I was not going to partake in that.
Well, no. Now what you got to do is you have to go back, and you have to get the landmine. Okay.
Uh huh.
So you get that landmine, you put it on the bridge, you bait him over, and have him.
I don't know if I could re-choose items. We'll see.
We'll see. Yeah, we're gonna play Legend of Dragoon 2. All these games.
That's
we're gonna
play. A sweet ass game.
Yeah. So there, it's gonna be a crazy summer, guys. Be there for it. Tell your friends.
Buy some dresses.
Tell your friends. Let's see. Nice. Oh man. So I can't believe we still have one more sesh with Skeeter.
With the Skeets.
Skeets McGee. Cause I'm itching to play Symphonia again.
And I think that's good that by saying goodbye to the tactics, we're saying hello to something that's truly a treat.
Yep. Yeah, because that's gonna be the hard part about summer. I mean, there aren't gonna be any more long plays versus episodes because it's gonna basically converge and be the same thing.
Yeah.
Because it's not like we can just play like the first 5 hours of Final Fantasy VII.
Can't do it.
You have to play that shit to completion.
Like I said, when I thought about Symphonia, I thought it was the perfect long play. Fucking JRPG, two players, active combat system. You can't go wrong with that.
Yeah.
Can't go wrong with that.
No. Yeah, and so, the only thing about the Final Fantasy Marathon is that I think that when we do Final Fantasy IX, we're gonna have to broadcast from Bill's place.
Good lord.
Because I've told Bill many a time that we're gonna play Final Fantasy IX from start to finish together. And can't.
Oh
snap, was that blind? Did you even know that was gonna happen?
Dog, of course.
Of course. Okay. Alright. Yes.
I'm getting into the spirit now.
Yes. Yeah, I can't wait for the summer to play all these crazy games.
Oh, did you see that? Do you see? We got a sidestep?
Ooh, how'd you do it?
Double click.
Ooh, there we go.
D to the C.
Yeah, you can play Final Fantasy IX two players.
All right.
Snap his neck. And by snap his neck, I mean slit his throat. Slice
it. We're not the killer chiropractor.
Ugh, be yourself.
Chiropractic.
You down, Bill?
Hey, fucker. Take your goddamn head off.
All right, Bill. Okay, I'll look at the controls.
Of what?
This game.
Well, I got it. I got it covered.
All right, so circle and R1 are interchangeable.
That's what I thought.
Yeah.
Come here, dog.
So, if you do the diagonal, it will make you, it'll make the camera rotate, apparently.
I am on a tree.
Diagonal, and back. I should have said.
Did I get him?
I don't know. Alright, let's see. Double tap, yeah, we saw that. You can do a dash forward and backwards as well.
Dude, this dog's got me in the corner. I'm up against the ropes.
Oh, you can roll?
Oh my god.
If you hold R1 and you double tap, you roll?
Good fucking lord.
Oh, and then do roll and X. I mean, do R1 and X.
I was in a fight for my life right now, so you want to let me in on something?
Alright, hold R1 and then press X. There you go. So run.
Oh, yeah. It turns around.
Yeah.
Like you flip.
And that's
okay.
Good.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, and then you, if you do R1 and you double tap, it does a roll. So you can roll. Yeah, there you go.
That's good.
Let's see. All right. So there we go. All right. So, what is Bill saying? Yeah, okay, so, alright. Bill says that we're going to turn his office into a studio, and we'll just marathon the shit out of Final Fantasy IX. I'm down. Because Bill and I have already played a Final Fantasy all the way through. basically in two sittings. So, we're seasoned veterans in that department.
What?
So Kevin said throw a shuriken, and when he said that, you threw a shuriken.
I threw lots of shurikens.
He said, Brother Link, do a barrel roll.
I love barrel rolls, and I love Peppy.
So Vexy says she wants to come out this summer, because it would be epic.
It would be epic.
We get the Vexy Vampire with the Jack and the Bear. It sounds epic. You get to see LA. I don't know if you've ever been to LA, but you would be able to see LA. You get to meet Bill. Let's see. All right, Haas. Thanks for stopping by. Enjoy your movie. I hope it is another diva movie, since that seems to be the common thread.
That looks like a pitfall.
18 hours for Final Fantasy VII. And we sat down and played that basically in two shifts. It was crazy. But yeah, I'm looking forward to that. I love Final Fantasy IX. I love marathoning Final Fantasies. And we can do our in-depth analysis on a scene-by-scene basis.
Oh, yeah.
Because that's all I've really wanted.
That's all I've ever wanted.
You know, it's harder to do that with a game like this. Real easy to do it with a game like Final Fantasy.
Can only they open the doors?
Maybe. I don't know. Maybe. Yeah, maybe. Jump!
Jesus Christ.
Alright, put that landmine down. Yeah.
Come here, you dirty bitch. Here, let me evoke him. This is what you get when you find a stranger in the Alps, dog.
Boom. Yep, alright. Did you put the mine down?
Nice. Did I put the mine down?
That tool didn't even see it coming.
As I, like, fucking stood in front of him and put it on the floor, like, eye contact.
Yeah, he made eye contact as you dropped the mine. Let's see, so, yeah, exactly. And that's part of why it'd be good to do it at your place, because Rick is part of that promise for Final Fantasy IX.
Rick?
Mm-hmm. One of Bill's friends.
Is that a sleepy? Is that a... Yes. He just woke his ass up!
And that's gonna be part of the marathon, too. You guys will be able to rename the characters. So, that'll be fun. We'll get some tool sheds, I'm sure. But maybe you'll come up with some new ideas. I know we're always gonna have a Skeeter. Skeeter's gonna replace, like, the Cid. You know... Oh, shit, did you chop his arm off?
Did I? I don't know. I don't even know what I'm doing.
Dude, look at that. That's his arm, man.
Oh, yeah!
Yeah, you chopped off his arm. Rename them all Bob. The real Master Mr. Popo says, OMFG Tenchu, my favorite game. Yeah, we were all Tenchu fans, too.
Yeah, man. Hey, if you like Tenchu, feel free to tell us where to go, because we're real lost.
Yeah, we decided to play this because we
loved it when we were young, but
we're old as fuck now.
We're all decrepit and sad.
We can't remember
that
things.
That looks like a hole. So I'm gonna.
There you go. Better to be safe than to be sorry. So the real Mr. Popo, tell us about your Tenchu experience.
Well, are we supposed to go down there?
Yeah, maybe. Look. Well, yeah, I was gonna say look down there.
No.
Nope. That would be unwise. Good thing it looks. Did your balls just drop like that? They went up and then they dropped again, and you just went through like some hormonal duress.
Dude, my goddamn tear glands just fired up. Like they were like, what? Get ready.
Can't wait to watch this on the replay. Oh man. There we go. That's awesome. Oh, that's so good.
I can't open
that's
that.
So good to me.
And this doesn't,
cheers.
And this doesn't seem to open.
I love the color of this beer, by the way.
It's pretty. I like how you get the mission where it's just like walk here.
Yeah. Oh yeah, maybe you have to go on the side.
Here's the thing, if I commit to one of those and I need to get back, I'm gonna be in trouble. Commit.
Nice. So Popo, what are you drinking? Are you drinking anything right now? Oh, look at that, there's nothing. There's nothing! God hates you. Alright, jump back on. All right, everybody, pray for Bear. Pray for Bear. Do it.
Here?
No.
Because then I'll grab on the way down.
Okay,
all right,
right? That's right. Yeah, probably.
Probably.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, yeah. Yeah, so Popo says he played the first two a lot, but Metal Gear Solid is his favorite game of PS1 and 2.
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah.
Of course. So, if that's the case, go back and watch our first episode. Our first episode was Metal Gear Solid, because...
Yep. Up on
Metal
the
Gear Solid
for
is amazing.
You!
Yeah, somebody give Popo the YouTube link, so you can go back and watch our Metal Gear game.
Give us damn hits.
Yeah. Actually, you know, so next week we're doing Morrowind, but... Another episode I really look forward to. Oh shit! Is a Snake Eater. Cannot wait to do Snake Eater.
Well, let's see if we can get it running.
Yeah, that's true. We might have to do a local recording of
it. It's on the console of which we do not speak.
That's true. Let's see. Blaze on till your day is gone. Moderator, get that YouTube.
Yes! Oh no! Oh, I wish you could have heard that, man.
That would mean go get to play too.
Is that a bear? That's a fucking bear!
What are you gonna do?
I'm gonna go this way for one thing. Yeah, okay, okay. Okay, okay, okay.
Stealth kill the bear.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, so, I'm gonna give. Yeah, there's a little look at it. Really, really, like, almost like a fluorescent orange. Real nice. Looks like it glows. It's you. Yeah, so, Popo, tell us about how you rank the Metal Gear games. Because I'm sure Metal Gear Solid is not the only one you've played. That is making a strange sound. Oh, dude, this bear is messing your shit up.
I'm dead.
Put a landmine down. Oh, shit.
He knocked the potion right out of my...
Oh, that sucks.
Let's take the whole level again, huh?
Yeah, let's do that. Well, at least you know where to go now.
It's one of those games...
Yep, you're just gonna get punished and punished
and punished
and punished. How do you rank the Metal Gear games, by the way? Just 1 through 3.
I can't do it.
If you had to, if pressed. Well, can you at least say what takes the number one spot?
Where are all my items?
If you die, you lose your items.
They're Dark Souls-ing me?
They're Dark Souls-ing you. Well, even in Dark Souls, you don't lose your items. It's actually not a Belgian beer. It's an India Pale Ale out of San Diego. It's by Port, which is an offshoot of Lost Abbey. Or it might be the other way around, but I think Port is the umbrella, actually. So I was wrong. See, bear, stealth, and rope hook that lets you scale buildings. This is like Far Cry 4. Boom! There you go. True dat, Flying V. Astute as always. Then everyone, tune in for Vexy's Outlast video.
Ow. I mean, I don't know. Metal Gear... I think that Metal Gear 2 is better than Metal Gear 1 in pretty much every way.
Yeah.
But that...
Yeah, the gameplay of 1 leaves something to be desired.
But... 1 is so fucking...
The story's fucking amazing,
it's dude. Fantastic. The gameplay ushers in a whole new paradigm of gameplay. It's just, like, unabashedly story-driven and awesome.
Yeah.
Within its own gameplay, like, the boss fights are fun and rewarding when you get through them.
Yeah. Agreed.
And then Snake Eater is fucking awesome. It's doing its own thing. It's like a stepping stone before we get the gameplay from 4, which is great. Yeah.
Honestly, I think that if I'm completely honest with myself... Mm-hmm. 1 is probably my favorite.
Yeah.
But not to play. I think my favorite to play is 3. But I also think that 3 is probably objectively the best.
I don't think so. I don't think...
If it's not 3, it's 1.
If... Are we talking, like, story-wise?
Like everything in its totality, because the story in 3 isn't as good as 1 or 2 probably.
Or 2.
But like the genre, like the satire almost of the genre, the awesome gameplay, the mechanics of the stealth system is really awesome. it's really, really streamlined in terms of like how you aim and all of that stuff, because that's always been one of the downfalls of the earlier installments. I think it's like, Snake Eater is doing something that, I mean, like the postmodern twist on 2, it's doing something like extremely interesting, where it's like, Snake Eater is a little prosaic in its approach to what it's, what it's doing.
Yeah.
But what it does is so good and so expert that, I just think that you're hard pressed to say there's anything like wrong with the game.
I don't think there's goddamn anything wrong with any of the games, is the problem.
Yeah, well, and that's the thing,
too. If it comes to 1, it's the gameplay. That puts it between 2 and 3.
And the only thing about the second one that I would say is, like, if you're splitting hairs, 3 is much more approachable, and it doesn't alienate.
Now, what do you mean by approachable? You need to elaborate.
People who are not versed in postmodern theory don't know what the fuck is going on in 2, And it, for some reason, it's harder for people... Jesus. It's hard... It's harder for people to realize that the postmodern form is a commentary on the game itself, rather than like comprehending that 3 is a commentary on the James Bond sort of like sleuthy spy itself.
I think the
levels of commentary are different.
I think it's unfair to say that makes it better though, because it's more accessible.
Well, again, if we're splitting hairs. And we have to say that, personally, you can say whatever, but in mass appeal, it has to be 3. But again, if we're objectively looking at it, it probably is 2.
Yeah, because 3 adds things like eating. It adds things like camo. Those don't inherently change the game. Core aspect changes came with 2.
Right. And I think that 3 kind of like perfected the mechanics up to that point. Some would argue that 4 has the best mechanics, but
4 does, honestly.
Yeah. So I mean, but the thing is that
4 fucked up on an entirely different level.
Yeah.
It's even Hideo's least favorite part 4.
Yeah, so...
And actually, as he ranks them, Snake Eater is his favorite.
Oh, wow. Okay, so Popo says that 1 is Metal Gear Solid. 2 is Metal Gear Solid 2. 3 is Metal Gear Solid...
So they get worse as they go on.
Yeah. Metal Gear Solid 4 is 3. And then he didn't like Snake in the Jungle.
Really?
Oh, man.
That is not something that a lot of people will say.
Yeah. Yeah, one of the
things... That's even Hideo's favorite, 3, Snake Eater.
Yeah, I love 3, dude.
They're all fucking great.
And actually, if you want to have a really good crash course on why Snake Eater's awesome, I would recommend Super Bunny Hop's analysis of Snake Eater. That's just Super Bunny Hop on YouTube. Bill showed me Super Bunny Hop's analysis. It's really good. The production quality is good. But even more importantly, the content is just really good. So for those of you looking to see why, like, either the case for Snake Eater being good or just reinforcing what you already think is true, go watch it. Let's see. Oh, okay, so... Popo said that he'll never finish Metal Gear 3.
Wow.
Because his PS2 crashed while he was
playing. Okay.
Well, but the funny thing is that if that were my case, I remember I got Fallout 3. I think like the weekend it came out, and I was really looking forward to it, and I put it in, and I got the Red Ring of Death.
Oh yeah.
I had seriously been playing it for about 40 minutes, and I got a red ring. Luckily, I was still under warranty.
That's Xbox, huh?
Yeah. I've actually had a pretty hard time thinking about,
oh my god,
what next-gen console I'm gonna get, because I am going to get one, because let's face it, Fallout 4 and...
is that actually happening?
Argonia. Yeah, it is. In Argonia.
Mmm! I was playing Morrowind, and one of the lizard people referred to it as Argonia, not Black Marsh.
Yeah. All right, yeah. So Nuclear Crack says, is it a good idea for Bunny Hop? No, probably not. You should probably play Snake Eater and then go to it.
We're not taking chances with jumps anymore.
Yeah, well, and the thing is I've been leaning towards PS4 simply because it also has the PSN and I can get backups of all the retro games and Suikoden 2 and all that shit.
But maybe one day we can get a capture card.
Ooh. Yeah, but I've also been thinking about Xbox One. But I don't know. But then I read that there's no backwards compatibility, so I mean, the one of the main reasons I would want an X-Bone be able to play my Xbox 360 games. But I don't know. Yeah, Jay, you seriously have to play Snake Eater. Snake Eater rocks. It certainly kills Bayonetta too.
You and your Bayonetta, dog.
Yeah, how'd you like Round Zeroes?
For the 2 hours that is there, Ground Zeroes is good.
I was asking Popo.
Well, I want to chime in too. I host the show too. Popo can chime in. It's just, you know, going to take him a little while before we hear it.
So, Spooky says that we need to get PS4 for Bloodborne, and he also says that MGS4 is his favorite. Yeah, it's probably because it's probably it's the most twitchy. Like, you don't need to rely on camo.
Have you seen Bloodborne?
No, I haven't.
Shit just looks like a Dark Souls knockoff.
Man. Well, it's the same company that made Dark Souls. Yeah. Let's see. Alright. How much is a capture card?
For a lot.
Oh, okay. What do you do with a capture card? I mean, like, what is it? So software or?
So
or
it's what? Hardware, and so we could hook it up to say your PS4 and stream that.
Yeah.
That's what a capture card does.
Yeah. I would want to do that. It'd make things easy.
Well, you know, larger bank accounts make things easier, huh?
Yeah, and I'm broke as hell. If you guys want to make a money pool for us to get a capture card,
yeah,
we will not say no. Let's see. Now, I guess my question is, if I had an X-Bone and you had a PS4, could we use the capture card on both?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, cool. Yeah, we should invest in one.
It's like $250.
Yeah, let's see. We'll look it up right here. Okay, your brother says that they're 100.
Really?
Yeah, he was looking on Google.
Why was he looking at that for?
Yeah, I'm just fucking around with you, Jay.
You fucking around with Jay?
Yes. You played The Last of Us, right?
Yeah.
Did you like it?
Yeah, I thought it was great.
Tell Popo about... Tell Popo your thoughts. And,
he doesn't like it?
No, he just asked. He just raised a question.
I think that Naughty Dog... Oh, shit. Hold on.
Is that the Crash Bandicoot?
Yep. But also Uncharted. Hold on. I'm in the middle of something.
Alright, so, let's see. Your brother just sent me a link.
Okay.
Yeah, HD capture card is 138.
So, The Last of Us, Naughty Dog. Now, Naughty Dog is not a developer that I enjoy.
Who'd that be?
You let them know. So, I think that they take too much from, like, movie tropes. They try to make their games a bit much like movies. And it takes the game aspect out of it, because their gameplay is never good. But The Last of Us struck a really nice balance between, like, cinematic qualities, storytelling, they kind of cut back the tropes, and they made a game with really fun mechanics as well. A really nice ending that I enjoyed, because it may be a little generic as you go through the game, but the ending really flips everything.
Oh! There you go.
What? What did he want?
You want to know if we were eating. And I said, no, you asshole, we're doing the show.
I gave my vague thoughts on The Last of Us. I think you would enjoy that one. Andrew?
Yeah.
Jack?
Yeah. Everybody, people who know me have told me that I'd like it, so...
It's a good game.
It's definitely on the list.
And like I said, I don't like Naughty Dog as a developing company.
Yeah.
But that was... They really nailed it on that one. Fun, stealth gameplay. So,
Big Trouble gave Hello Blue the t-shirt that the girl wears in that game.
Not Ellen Page?
And then, Popo doesn't understand Uncharted.
It's dumb.
It's stupid. The mice come out to play. And thank you, Bill. And your laundry can wait. You have important responsibilities.
Shit. I'm gonna die, dog. I can't.
The control suck, dude.
How am I gonna get mauled by my spirit animal?
I know.
How? Let's see. Do these people even want to see this again?
I don't think so. I think we should boot up Tails, because that's what I want. Man, in my heart of hearts.
It's like...
Or either that, or we should end Final Fantasy Tactics
now tonight. Here's the thing. If I had some items...
Yeah, it wouldn't be so bad.
You know, I'd put a landmine. Make the bears step on a landmine.
So here are the closing remarks on Tenchu.
Wait, I gotta give it one more.
We are inept. We suck. And we were better when we were young. But I think any of you would have been able to tell us that. Yeah, I mean, like, this game didn't... I'm not convinced that this game aged well. In the controller department. I think that, like, the aesthetic is kind of neat. No other game is really doing what this game is doing. you know, capitalizing off of the ninja thing, anyways. You get, like, the Oni games later. What is that? Oni Musha or something. But, I mean, at the time, Tenchu's kind of, like, its own thing.
Honestly, not even putting the health on the floor for me here?
Nope. You had too many tries.
No, it's right there. It's right there.
Let's see. What do we got here? Delete. Yeah, so Vexy agrees. It didn't age well. The graphics are silly. The environment graphics are silly. I think that there's a certain cool factor to, like,
it's
these...
dark.
Yeah. The sound effects, I actually like.
The music.
The music is cool. But the gameplay is wonky at best. And the controllers are jank. You can't have a free-roaming 3D action-adventure game like this unless you have a good camera. I'm sorry. You just can't. I like the alert system. It's a lot like, you know, basically like your basic Skyrim sort of thing, where you have the eye that's either open or it's shut, all that stuff. So that's good. But I mean, overall, this game's clunky as hell. But that said, I'd be interested to see how Wrath of Heaven aged. Maybe we'll come back to Wrath of Heaven once we can emulate.
Yeah, once we get that unlocked.
Yeah. So, we'll see. Try to get this bear, and we'll see what happens.
I'm just streamlining this freaking level now.
Yeah, I never played Tenchu Z, so,
I've never even heard of Tenchu Z.
I think it was for Xbox or Xbox 360 or something like that. Yeah, so Big Trouble says he thinks that Tenchu was the first game to make, like, assassinations, like a little cutscene, you know?
Yeah. That could be true.
Yeah, I would love to see Tenchu, like, I guess, like, Tenchu Reborn, you know?
Yeah.
This is a monopoly on ninja games. There's really no other ninja game that's, you know, reputable or whatever.
Yeah, I mean, there's Ninja Gaiden, but let's face it.
Ninja Gaiden sucks.
That's not a ninja game.
I fucking hate Ninja Gaiden.
Ninja Gaiden is one of those games like Dark Souls where people like it because it's hard.
Yeah.
Even though it's hard for the wrong reasons.
Mm-hmm.
That being said, I do like that genre. I like Devil May Cry. I like I said, I don't necessarily like Bayonetta. I like that genre. I like the hack and slash. I think it's fun.
Well, yeah, I mean, I'm a sucker for the Dynasty Warriors games, and people would be like, you're an idiot for that, but no, I love them. They're my guilty pleasure games. But speaking of Dynasty Warriors, I'm a real sucker for a specific game. Not Kessen 1, but Kessen 2. I loved Kessen 2. That's a fucking great game. It's not good, but it's fun, and I like it. Yeah, so Popo brings up, like, God of War. I was never a God of War
fan. Yeah, that genre, I do enjoy.
Yeah. I can enjoy it. We'll play Hyrule Warriors with you, Bill. Don't worry. What's Hyrule Warriors?
It's Dynasty Warriors with a... It's Zelda characters, but it's Dynasty Warriors.
Dynasty Warriors 1 to 3. Oh, Devil May Cry 1 to 3.
See, that game is... It takes a lot of skill, quite honestly. It's not so spammy.
Yeah. Yeah, I liked Devil May Cry, the little I played of it. I didn't really like the aesthetic. I thought it was kind of, like, cheesy gothic. And, I don't know, I could never really get into that game. But I knew that it was, like, certifiably good for that time, you know? Because there were games like Chaos Legion that were trying to do the same thing, but... Their aesthetic was even worse, and the gameplay was even worse, so it was a net negative on all counts. Yeah, we're pretty sure this has been circular, and by circular, I mean, not really circular, because you make, for at least, like, 90 degrees, you make progress in a circle. We have not made any progress. But thank you for...
Whoa!
Yeah, wow.
I'm done. He lit me on fire. The bear lit me on fire. All right, I can't fight that. Guys. Well, I can't fight that.
Well, here's the thing. Okay, so we've been playing this for an hour and 43 minutes. So let's give some closing remarks. And...
Well, here's the closing remark. The ninja Rikimaru lies broken, a shadow in life, in death, a failure.
Damn.
That's what they're...
That's mean.
In the words of Cowboy...
That's like not even necessary.
In the words of Cowboy Bebop, I gotta carry that weight.
You gotta carry that weight.
I gotta carry that weight.
Yeah, guys, so, unsuccessful, but but enlightening, I think.
To be perfectly honest, I did enjoy playing it. I think it's fun. It's fucking hard, which is how I remember it. I remember it being really goddamn hard. But if we can relate this to Dark Souls, I mean...
Let's have a Dark Souls discussion.
Look at how I was playing this level. Hold on, let me... The music just kicked back on. Look how long the level took me the first time. And then I just started fucking streamlining it.
Right, so...
Which is good. I like that.
The thing about Dark Souls is... Well, I'm not even going to say Dark Souls because... I played Dark Souls up until Gwyn, the Firekeeper. And then I played about 3 hours of...
You took it all, I see.
Well, I poured
I
you.
Know, I'm just...
All right, so... I played Dark Souls 2 for about 3 hours. Now, Dark Souls 1 and Dark Souls 2 are like day and night. They have similarities. You know, day and night are both rooted in temporality, and that's about it.
Christ.
But seriously, that's about it. So it's like the same thing with Dark Souls. It's like Dark Souls is rooted in the same basic premise that they're both built in it's going to be hard, and built in it's you're going to die. Now, with Dark Souls 1, it really embraces that and even though some would say it doesn't forgive you, it really does. Because part of the game is like, okay, you died. But that's okay because you get to go back and do it better.
Yeah.
In Dark Souls 2, it's like, okay, you died. Now you get to go back and do it better, but it's going to be harder.
Yeah.
And the thing is like, it's supposed to get easier. You're supposed to get better,
yeah.
And therefore it becomes easier. The level doesn't change, you change. In Dark Souls 2, it's not the same thing. You could get better, but the thing is...
They're going to take your land.
Well, no, they take away 10% of your life every time you die until you're down to 50% life. And when you're just starting out, like when you're fighting that first boss and you have 50% life, if you're off by a pixel, you die in one hit. And that was what kept on happening to me in the first boss. Like, the roll function doesn't work the same way. And so I'd roll out of the way, and I'd get clipped. Whereas in Dark Souls 1, you wouldn't get clipped. You'd just roll back, yeah. And you'd be safe, and you'd come up, and you'd start to go again. But it's just like, even if you roll, you just, boom, you get clipped, and you die.
Yeah.
Whereas if it was Dark Souls 1, yeah, you could get clipped, but you wouldn't die because you'd still have 100% life.
So let's contextualize this. Difficulty is something that is lacking in modern gaming.
Mm-hmm.
And we are very hard up for difficulty. But when we come up to conceptions of difficulty, I mean, we could leave it to the game grumps, you know, Ego Raptor and Jontron, the original game grumps. They're on a lot more grumps now.
I'm on Spoony.
Yeah. And you talk about, you want a game to be hard, but you want it to feel like it's your fault when you lose.
Yeah.
So those old twitchy games like Mega Man, you know.
Contra.
Contra. A newer game like Super Meat Boy, which they brought up, which is just Shovel Knight. Anything that's a platformer. It's like when you lose at that, you're like, shit, man, that was my fault. Like, I fucked up.
Yeah.
You know, because you can't blame the controls. You can't blame the movement. It's like, yeah, that all feels super smooth. I just couldn't do it. And that, to me, isn't something that happens in Dark Souls. It wasn't something that was happening in Tenchu Part 1. I still like Tenchu Part 1. Well, I actually kind of want to get my hands back on it.
Honestly, Tenchu... I would say that Tenchu is kind of like Dark Souls 1.
Yeah.
Dark Souls 1... the more that I play it, the more it's like, okay, actually, this is my fault. Dark Souls 2, it's definitely not my fault because I'm really good at Dark Souls 1.
Yeah.
I've learned from my mistakes. I learned what I can do. I've maximized all of my equipment to work for me rather than against me, which is part of learning that game. I'm really good at Dark Souls 1, and ergo, I should be good at Dark Souls 2. But Dark Souls 2 is artificially difficult. Like, the maps are just really fucked up. So much so that even if you play really well... I mean, like, you know, there's some people who have it down to a science. Like, they know exactly at what second to press the button. Like, they could do it blindfolded. But that's not good, you know? Like, you shouldn't be able to crack a game like that where you can play it blindfolded. That's not good game design. Good game design is where, you know, again, it comes down to you not memorizing the map, but being able to work within the confines of the map. And Dark Souls 1 and Tenchu 1 both do that. Dark Souls 2 definitely does not. Or if it does, it does to a lesser extent.
Something about sequels. And that's what Bill is saying right now. He's saying he's doing a playthrough of the Mega Man X series. He's on 5 right now. And he says it's shitty, and that is a shitty one. The way I would rank the Mega Man games, we start off Mega Man X, fucking awesome. Mega Man X 2, really goddamn awesome. Mega Man X 3, really shitty. Mega Man X 4, awesome again. Mega Man X 5 and 6, shitty. Mega Man 7, X 7, interesting. Everything after that, who cares?
Yeah.
I mean, I guess, yeah, lightning doesn't always strike 7 times.
That'd be very surprising if it did.
Is there a franchise that just hits it every time? I mean, Metal Gear is on it.
Well...
It really is.
Well, okay, so it depends. You know, the case could be made that the Elder Scrolls has.
Okay.
You know, when Arena came out.
No.
It came, here's, just hear me out.
No.
So now Arena doesn't hold up, but when Arena first came out, it was that. It was that first round of, you know, what should a computer game be? Well, a computer game is meant for people who are playing computer games, and at the time, that was just D&D players. And so Arena is just D&D, but on a computer.
It has zero conveyance, which is the problem with Metal Gear. The very first Metal Gear, and we're talking about games that should not have had sequels.
Yeah, and so
I'm glad they did.
Yeah. So if we're making the Metal Gear analogy, we can take out Metal Gear, like the Nintendo and the Super Nintendo.
That's what I'm talking about.
So let's take those out. Let's start with Daggerfall, because Daggerfall.
I don't know about that.
Yeah. So even though Daggerfall,
because the Arena was awful, you can't say that was a good game.
No. So even though Daggerfall has anachronistic controls,
Alex Toma.
Oh, what's up, Andrew? How's it going? So, Daggerfall. With Daggerfall, you have a game that right now has anachronistic controls, but no other game in the history of gaming has had a bigger world. The world of Tamriel in Daggerfall is the size of the British Isles. It's fucking enormous. And the thing is that even though it's randomly generated...
Oh, okay. It's like Minecraft.
Well, it's randomly generated, but the thing is it's randomly generated in such a way that everybody who plays Daggerfall will have the same map. Like, the coding is homogenous across all the games. It creates random environments in the same way. And so, in Daggerfall, you can go to Morrowind... You can go to Cyrodiil. You can go to Elsweyr. You can go to the Shimmering Isles. You can go to Hammerfall. You can go to all these places. And the thing is that even though a lot of the space in between is randomly generated, it's all randomly generated within the continent-specific aesthetics. And so it makes for a very lively world. And apparently... Given the enormous range, it is dense as well. So it's not like the Oblivion problem, which I love Oblivion, but Oblivion is not dense like Skyrim is dense, even though Skyrim's not very dense.
Morrowind is dense.
Jesus. Morrowind is the best game for that reason.
You're going to see next week when we throw on Morrowind. We'll put on my character just to get a look at it. I 28 hours in that game so far.
Nice.
Fucking 10th of the map.
I know, and it's amazing, dude. It's amazing.
Like
Morrowind is serious. It's the sweet spot.
I've seen the south of Varen. What is it?
Vardenfall.
Vardenfall.
Vardenfell.
Yeah, I've seen the south of it.
Yeah, dude. Like Morrowind, you cannot begin to have a serious discussion about the Elder Scrolls unless it's rooted in Morrowind.
Morrowind is not without flaw.
I was about to say,
even outside the gameplay, I do have a problem with the world. I'll get to that next week.
Right.
I think that's more important there.
I have less problems with the world, probably.
I don't have a lot of problems with the world, but they're there. I think, because like I said, the first Elder Scrolls I played was Skyrim, and Morrowind's already doing me better. Like, I love the world in Morrowind. Especially after taking boats to other towns and seeing how aesthetically varied everything is, they keep surprising me with the new shit they could come up with. It's incredible.
Yeah.
Let's save that for another week.
All right.
Well, let's ask this: Would these good people here like to see some Symphonia? Would you like to play some Symphonia?
I just want to get tactics over with.
I don't think we have enough time for that. We got a 6 level downward into the dungeon.
I think we should do it. I think we should try.
Okay.
All right, we'll give it a try.
We'll give it a try.
We have to cut the stream so that we can edit. Well, actually, let's see. Let's see if I can edit this off the cuff.
No, let's do it so it'll be easier to upload.
Okay, yeah. All right, so we're going to cut the stream for just a few minutes, and we'll be back to play Final Fantasy Tactics.
The death of a skeeter.
Yeah, the death of a skeeter.
Modern American play.
So, that said, this will only take about 5 minutes, or maybe just a little bit longer, but we will be back. So, stay in the chat. We'll be chatting throughout the whole thing, so don't worry. We'll be right back. Thanks for tuning in to this episode of Tenchu. And for those of you who are watching this retroactively,
don't get lit on fire by a bear.
Don't do that. But also subscribe to our YouTube channel, like us, all that stuff. And then follow us on Twitter at Beer Video Games TV. And in the meantime, keep your games good and your beer craft. And we'll see you next time.